Welcome to learning and manual testing. Today we are going to deal about the other methods, other techniques. Those other techniques are nothing but testing techniques. Okay, first one we have learned, right? Equivalence bar testing. Already we have covered in earlier cases. Okay, partitioning. Okay, second one is boundary value analysis. These two has been covered in earlier classes. The third one, what we are checking here, nothing but decision table. Okay, just a minute, let me save the document. Okay, decision table. Okay, one more decision table, or else we'll call it as another name is cost effect table. Okay, one more decisions. If you see the word decision, we are taking decisions. So let's take an example for this new page. So business given a one condition, one requirement, like validate the login section for ABC bank. Something like they ask it, their requirement has to validate the login section for ABC bank. Some bank is there where I need to validate the how the login will happens. So for that I will take the conditions, like obvious, what are the conditions we'll have username and password and my condition, how the condition look like. Let's consider if my username is correct, valid, and my if my username is valid and password is valid, what can be the condition? Should user should log in, right? This is my condition. The second one is, if username is valid and password is invalid, in that conditions user error throw. Error should see, like I will see. Next one is, if the username is invalid and password is valid, obviously in this condition also I should see error. Okay, if both are invalid, in this condition also I will see the error message like this. For the I need to save it here, right? Let's take decision table. Just stop. Okay, we have already with name like this, right? Just a minute. Like that we have the conditions. So let me keep in a box. Let me keep in a box like this. Username, password, like this, for ease understanding purpose. Okay, now you are clear, right? For that, for valid username, for different conditions, For a different combination, I should have conditions, right? For this requirement has been, this requirement has been convert into a tabular format. These are my decisions in a table. So depending upon the user needs, I need to prepare in a tabular format with my conditions. In other words, I'm taking decisions in a tabular format. I'm taking conditions in a tabular format, nothing but decision table. It's nothing but if the user, what are the rules here given, right? Either we don't know how the rules will be looks like, right? So something like complex. If the user rules are complex, we are going to prepare in a tabular format. For that, we'll use decision table. If the user rules are complex, we are going to prepare in tabular format to write test cases. For what purpose? To write test cases. To write test cases. I will explain how to write test cases like this. You see here, if on seeing this statement, do you know how many test cases we'll get? No, right? But if you derive into tabular format, obviously I know we have 1, 2, 3, 4 test cases I can get. So which is nothing but on seeing the user requirements, we can't know how many test cases we can derive. But when we convert into tabular format, we can easily understand, we can easily get how many test cases we'll get. For that, I have real-time example. One real-time scenario is there. Let me open that document. I'll show. This is my personal document where I keep all those things here. Okay, let me go down. Okay. Yes, dissertation table. Good. Let me see whether I can minimize this one or not. Let's have in 100. No, 100 is not good. Let's go 110. Okay, 110 seems fine for me. Let me take this as a screenshot. Okay. Like this, I'll take a screenshot and I will work on it. I'll do experiment on this. Okay, Control V, okay, to lower it. So this is my, let's consider a real-time scenario. If the business rules it looks like this, sorry, just a minute. Okay, let me give a bit more. Okay, let's try to manage here itself. So we have one condition. This is the business rules. Okay, different color. These are my business rules. Okay, these are my different business rules. For that rules, I need to create how many test cases are I need to generate, how many test cases I will get from this rule. So for that, I don't know how can I write test cases, but now try to create in a tabular format. You see here, we have two conditions here, right? If else, okay. Try to understand what is if else here. If else is nothing but if the statement is wrong, then only else condition will execute. I will start. Okay, so we have few conditions. Else part is very low, right? Now try to implement else part. So if is failed, if condition will get failed, then I will else part will execute. What is if condition here? Driver age is less than 25. If else is executing is nothing but driver age should be more than 25, then only this else part will execute. So if I want to check for else part, that driver age should be more than 25, right? So see here. Yes, I could see something like that driver is more than 25. Okay, else we have two conditions. The first condition is driver, if in else condition, if AF is equal to Y, if the driver is not met with any accidents, if the condition is true, then is such something like, consider it as a tax, then he doesn't have any tax. For else part, first condition is if AF equal to Y, then my surcharge should be no surcharge. So whatever showing yellow color is nothing but my conditions. Okay. AF equal to Y, driver is more than 25, else condition. AF equal to Y, what is the surcharge here? The surcharge should be zero. So whatever the uncolored is nothing but the taxes or surcharges. So surcharge is zero. Yes, this condition is clear. The next is else if, see here, for if this is else condition, okay? AF equal to N, then my surcharge is 0.07. So more than 25, else part, more than 25, and AF equal to N. In that condition, what is the value here? 0.07, nothing but 7%. Yes, my second condition is corrected. The next, if you see any conditions are there, no conditions are there. So I will jump into if part. If part will contains driver age should be less than 25, right? So in every condition, the driver age is less than 25 only. Okay, let me control it here. Okay, so in that first condition is if AF equal to N less than 25, AF equal to N less than 25, AF equal to N, what is surcharge here? It is 0.20, something like 20%, right? Yeah, that is nothing but 20%, it's clear. If you see here, this if has been ended here, another else part starts, which is nothing but if this is not true, then it will go. If it is not true, means AF equal to Y only, A is less than 25, AF equal to Y, then else part will execute, because if it is fails, it will go here. If it is fails, if it is executing here is nothing but it got failed, right? So less than 25, AF equal to Y, then only it will start. See here, less than 25, AF equal to Y, what is this part condition? The gender is female. Less than 25, Y, then gender is female. What is the condition here? It is 0.10, and remember the 10%. Yeah, that is here, right? I could be able to see 10%. Like that, if else part is wrong, then my else, another else will start. This it is, if it fails, then it this else will start. Less than 25, AF equal to Y, driver age, driver gender is not female, nothing but male. That's why everything is male here, everything is Y here. Like that, it. And if education is no, less than 25, AF equal to Y, gender equal to male, and his education is no, then my what is charge here? 0.15, 15%. Like that, every condition has been derived depending upon the rules. Okay, like that, every rules has been derived here. So like that, every values will come. So if you see here, can we know how many risks we can get? No, right? So when you convert into tabular format like this, we can know every column is nothing but one test case. If I ask you, what is the surcharge if the driver age is less than 25, AF equal to Y, and gender equal to male, education is Y, and college is no? So for that, what I'm showing here, nothing but this is the values. For the, what is the surcharge here? The surcharge is obvious, 12%. If I ask the question here, same question here, no, you can't get it, right? So that's why if we are converting, if the business rules are seems are complex, we are converting to tabular format, and we can direct write the test cases on these 8 conditions. So we'll get 8 test cases with the different conditions. This is nothing but decision table. Okay, I've given two examples, right? The first one is the basic example. There's nothing but login section page. So we are just like preparing a tabular format and knowing how many test cases. Later we'll go to the some complex scenario and we are getting how many test cases here. So next, the fourth one is, okay, orthogonal array. What about array? Array is nothing but a collection of characters, right? So this is nothing but it is homogeneous heterogeneous. It is always heterogeneous. It can store any values. It can't store numbers only. It can store special characters can store, numbers it can store, alphabets it can store, underscore, any values it can store, right? So like that it will contain different values. Something like here also we'll have different values. Orthogonal array is nothing but checking the cross functionality of an application. For that I have diagram. Let me show the diagram. Cross fun, what about a cross functionality? So how can I divide a cross functionality of an application? So let me open the diagram. For time being, open it. Where I can open? Oh, it doesn't open, right? Okay, it is open. Orthogonal array. Don't know. I will have that one. Orthogonal array. No. Okay, like this. So let's take an example. Cross functionality, right? Let's take. I have taken different devices. The first device in a devices. For device, I have different cross devices like Samsung, Redmi, Nokia, iPhone, Lava, Oppo, and Vivo. I have different devices here, and I have different browsers: Chrome, IE, Mozilla, UC browser, Safari browser, Opera browser, and I have different operating systems. What are the operating systems here? Windows, Linux, Android, iOS, Ubuntu, Red Hat, something like Mac. So here I have different cross functionalities. Like, so let's take real time customer has come up with an idea, right? Could you please check my Gmail in different browsers and different operating system and different devices. So for that, how can I check? So for that, I have taken real time example here like this. So I have how many devices here? I have 70 devices. And how many browsers? I have 6 browsers. And how many operating systems? I have 7 operating systems. Original, if I want to check that Gmail application in all the conditions, in for all the permutation combinations, how many test cases I will get? 7 into 6 into 7. That's not 294 test cases I need to write here. Okay? Which is nothing but I need take an example. That's one the basic example. Don't consider it as a real-time example. So Samsung. So first to check Gmail and Samsung, what I need to do? I need to install Windows into Samsung, and I need to install all the browsers and check the Gmail application. If Gmail application is working fine, what I will do? I will uninstall the Windows and I will install Linux, and I need to install all the browsers, and again I need to check the Gmail application. Later I move to install Android into Samsung, and I need to install all the browsers, and I need to check the Gmail application, all the browsers. Like that, we need to check all the combinations. For all the combinations, I need to get 294 test cases. It is not at all feasible to check the applications. It is not a good practice to check the application like this with this number of test cases. So if you have more number of test cases, then it will be more complex. Okay. So what we'll do? We'll try to decrease number of test cases here. How we can try to decrease number of test cases? I will write definition here. Cross format of checking the cross functional of application by using permutations and using permutations and combinations. So something like we're learning in on our plus two, right? NPR and CR, something like this here also. So what I will do, I'll randomly pick one flow and try to implement the flow. For that, I given it on lines here. So first of all, what I will do, I will try to install IE, and I will install Linux in my Samsung, and I'm trying to check in IE browser, something like, and I will go for Nokia. In Nokia, I will install Opera, and I will check in Windows. In Redmi, as per sequence only, I will going in Redmi. I will install UC browser, and I will check in Android. And in iPhone, I will install Safari, and I will check in iOS. In Lava, I will install Chrome, and I will check in Ubuntu. In Oppo, I will check in Mozilla, and I will check in Mac. In Vivo, I will check in Safari, and I will check in Red Hat. Something like I have given the permutation combination. So see here, I've written the things here also. Okay, let me maximize. Don't know whether it will look or not. See here, yes, written the conditions like test cases. Okay, like this. So first test case nothing but Samsung, IE, and Linux, right? See here, Samsung, line and Linux. Okay, and second test case is Nokia, Oppo, and Windows. Here Nokia, and I will go here Oppo and Windows. Something like I have written here. I'll take a random test case six nothing but Oppo, Mozilla, Mac, threat Oppo, Mozilla, and Mac. Something like I have written test case like this. So don't consider only we have some test cases, not like that. So if you want to write more test case, you can go for 13 or 40, 50 like test case you can write using a permutation combinations. Take any random combination, right? Try to write a test case like this. Don't write 294 test cases. Better to write more 50 or 60, or depending upon your bandwidth and depending upon your time and flexibility. And one more thing, the note, first note is we need to take the approvals from the client. For that, we need to take the approvals from the client, like saying that, so here we are going to, when we are going for checking the original 294 test case not feasible, so we are using the orthogonal array technique. So, and try to decrease number of test cases like that, and we have used these permutation combinations and written this type of these number of test cases. So could you please tell me whether these are feasible or not? Like that, we need to take the approvals from the customers. If the customer is okay with these combinations, then we can start the testing of the application. Like that, the orthogonal array will be deal for cross functionalities of an application. Okay. Let me see if anything is missed from my side. Okay, everything is covered, right? Okay, so okay, that's it for the day. Thank you. The techniques part has been completed.